Welcome to Twin Bush. There's a new tips and tricks episode today about the manual safety release on lifts. It is located in the post, on the lifting carriage. Here we see a piece of the safety catch that is mounted on the carriage. Using this model, we can see how it works a bit better. The safety catch has an adjustment screw. I'll now explain to you exactly what can be adjusted. I'll show you an incorrect setting first, the reasons for it and how to avoid it. Ideally, the catch should lock itself gradually into the locking positions while lifting. You have to pull the release cable to descend. The rotary latch releases the safety catch and the catch should also remain free while lowering. In this case, the catch folds back into the locked position because the rotary latch doesn't keep the catch open when lowering. Now we drive up a bit. Release, keep pulling from the cable for this, and lower into a position in which the adjustment screw is accessible. In the special case that the catch folds back continuously, it's because this screw is screwed in too far. The screw must now be turned back a bit. I have now adjusted it the other way around. The other problem that can happen is, the lift is released with the cable, and while going up again the rotary latch should fold back and give the catch the opportunity to lock itself again. But in this case nothing folds back. The catch is perfectly set now. This means that when the cable is pulled, the rotary latch turns as far as it goes. This way you can lower the lift perfectly without the latch folding back. And while lifting, the parts fold back and the catch locks again. When the catch is perfectly set, its behavior can still be affected if, for example, the lift is greased correctly on the inside. Because the latch slides on the same area where the lift was greased, the friction on this piece changes a bit as well. This can also change the behavior of the safety catch, which you can readjust a little with the adjustment screw.